To start, we will create a program that will add two numbers. Here, we will create three integers using a keyword int variables a, b, c like this. Here, we want to tell you that we can create as many variables in a single line while using int keywords only one time. Now, we put value 15 in a and value 10 in b like this. Now, we do c is equal to a plus b. The statements are followed by a semicolon. I've explained the reason in the very first chapter. Now, we print the variable c and execute the program. Well, you got your answer as 25. So what have we done? We have created three variables. A and b act as input variables, while c stores the result of an expression that is a plus b. We print the result. It's a pretty simple program, but we can't have fixed values. That is, a is equal to 15 and b is equal to 10. And everyone doesn't know programming languages. We need to prepare a program which can be used by anyone. We don't have to write values of a and b via editing the program. How to achieve this? Today, we will be learning a new function called as scanf. Scanf takes the input from the users and does the processing. Let's open with the same example. Only difference here is we will not assign a is equal to 15 and b equal to 10, but we will accept inputs from user and do the addition. Our program is the same. We are removing the two statements, that is a is equal to 15 and b equal to 10. Now we will write scanf like this. Let's execute the program. We have executed the program, but still we see the blank screen. It's because of scanf. It's waiting for our input. Now, since we have specified scanf twice, it will wait for two inputs. Let's see. I'm typing value 21 and pressed enter. One input is gone and now the program is waiting for the second input. Now, we enter the value 4 and again press enter. Now you see, the output C scanf waits for input. Once input is given, the program runs the expression a plus b, stores the result in C, and then prints the value of C. Before understanding the scanf and this program in detail, let's modify it so that it's more user-friendly. After declaring variables, we are writing printf statement to give a title and another line to ask the user to give the first input like this. Same for the second input. Now, we will print result in a decent way. Let's execute the program. As we execute it, the system displays the title first, then asks for first and second input. We will input the values 12 and 18, and then it displays the result.